So I'm back again. No scarf this time. No scarf needed this time. So I'm just gonna be olo dolo and okay. But I just wanna say I'm very, you know, proud of myself. This whole targeted individual thing, it really taught me a lot about myself, like how to stand up for myself. I know I said a lot, but literally it did, because like before, like I would always be like, so like I wasn't passive, but I felt like I let a lot of fucking shit fucking slide, you know, like a lot of shit, you know, just with people that I would know and conversate with, even the guys that I dated, you know, family. And like this time I chose a different route, you know. Some people say that it's the fork in the road. You could go left, you could go right, and I chose to go straight. I was like, no, I'm gonna make my own fucking route. You're not gonna tell me which way I'm gonna go. I'm gonna go which way I wanna go. You know what I mean? This is a repeated pattern. It's almost like a test, I guess. I've done this many times. I did it when I was 18 and I ended up getting a relationship. I did it when I was 27 and I ended up getting a relationship. And this time I chose not to do it, because you know, when you know better, you do better. Like I said, I kept trying to figure out what was the problem. Is it me that's the problem? But, you know, maybe it's because I don't compromise. Maybe because I was cheating before. Maybe it's because of my family. Maybe because of this, because of that. And when I eliminated everything and I tried everything, I figured out that it wasn't me. It was the world, you know. I was watching this girl's video. I forgot her name, I'm so sorry, but she's a very fucking smart ass targeted individual. And she, you know, she was speaking some truth. She was like that the earth and the world are two different things, you know. In the Bible it says be in the world but don't be of the world. The Bible is a very specific thing. If the earth and the world were the same thing, it would be saying be in the earth but not of the earth. But the earth is just the physical thing. The world is the soul of the earth. The same way like your mind. The Bible says guard your mind, guard your heart. Your mind is not your brain. You know, your brain is your brain. Your brain is your left side, your left hemisphere of your mind. Your brain. This is your brain. Your brain is everything, but it's more like this side. Because you don't really use your right side of your brain. That's the truth. Your mind is more like your right side. Your mind is your spiritual brain, you know. It's logic, you know. So I chose a different route, you know. I chose to go differently because I figured out that the world was not what I thought it was. Everything was just strange. I kept like everything the world taught me was a lie. And it, yeah, that is a very hard reality to kind of like, you know, come into. You know, you've been taught all this shit about fucking Jesus. Jesus is real and God is real. But the thing is that some parts of the Bible have been screwed up in order to keep the masses more obedient and complacent and passive, you know, into authority. Like, we need to use this book because everybody wants to make God happy. Everybody wants to, you know what I mean, be under good authority, but they abused it, you know. That's why I chose to follow God, because God is not a God that abuses his authority. I mean, God is God. God could do what the fuck he wants. He could burn a bitch down and kill you, murder you, whatever he want to do, but he doesn't do that. He's like very gentle. He's very loving. He doesn't force anything on you. You know what I mean? He's a, you know, you come to me on your own free will type of God. That's why he gave us free will. Free will is a gift. And, you know, in the world, they don't give you free will. They try to enslave you. They, you know, this book, so many people have died to give us this knowledge. And they've used this book to enslave people, you know, and to indoctrinate you and to, you know, lie to you. But the book is very black and white in the things that it say. And like I said, trying to figure out the truth. Once you figure out that, okay, I did everything that the world told me what was what. They said love is this and that, but I didn't like the world's definition of love. I liked it God's definition of love, you know. And, you know, the world tells you this is normal, and this is what you got to do with your boss and when you're working. This is how you got to serve your, you know, da-da-da-da-da. And I didn't like the world's definition. The Bible's definition seemed pretty good, but I didn't like the world's definition. So, you know, here I am on this journey, you know, searching for the truth because I want the truth. They say the truth shall set you free, and it is true because before I was living a lie in the matrix, you know, going to parties with motherfuckers I really don't like, going to Thanksgiving and eating this fucking dry ass turkey every fucking year with family members that I really don't like, and fucking an old disgusting nigga who's a goddamn pedophile and a sexual fucking demon, and you know, I really didn't like him like that. It was like a contract that we're gonna be faithfully to each other, but that was like I was never really, really like in love with him like that, you know what I mean? Like, we're like I want to be with you. It was like, well, you're gonna take care of me, so I'll do it. So once I kind of like learned the truth, I was like, you know, I don't want to just be going with niggas just because he could take care of me or he got money or whatever. Like, I want what the Bible says, the truth, you know. So I'm on this path for the truth. Like I said, I didn't go the path that was given to me. You go left, you go right. I made my own path. I said, I don't want to go either way. I'm going to go straight. Yeah, well, guess what? You know, you can't go straight because no one's ever gone that road before. Well, I'm going to go. Because, bitch, we don't know. If nobody went there before, then, bitch, I'm finna try to go there and see what's beyond the fucking lines. You know what I mean? We don't know. You know? I mean, the Bible tells you that... Okay, it tells you how a husband and a wife should be, right? It says, wives, respect your husband. Respect them. Don't be motherfucking talking down to him and shit. And with gang stalking, the way that the world works, everybody's a narcissist. So it's impossible to respect your husband when you always fucking having to be a narcissistic bitch to him. And then it says, husbands, love your wives more than you love your own self. So much so, you have to love her the same way that Christ loved the church, so much that he died for her. You don't love your wife because, bitch, you gang stalking her and you're a narcissistic piece of shit that cheats on her. You know, you don't want nobody to cheat on you, but you're cheating on them. So therefore, the definition of love according to the world is a contradiction, you know? The world teaches you the Bible, but the world does not even follow one fucking rule in the Bible whatsoever. When I say whatsoever, I mean like whatsoever. So, like, I wanted what was in the Bible. That's the one thing that I always say. When you want something, you go after it. Don't let nobody tell you shit. If you a goddamn hooker and your motherfucking pussy costs $1,000, don't let nobody tell you, oh, well, yo, you pricing that shit too high. It don't matter if you're a crack hoe and you done been out of commission. Your pussy need a, you know, tune up. If your price is $1,000, bitch, you set your shit because it's your pussy. You feel me? And this is my body. This is my spirit. This is my mind. This is my time. And I'm not going to let nobody tell me what I do and don't deserve. Like, I want what the Bible got. The Bible say, this is how a husband's supposed to be. This is how a wife's supposed to be. This is how life's supposed to be. This is how government's supposed to be. This is how the world is supposed to be. And what God said is what I want. That's why you gotta, in your mind, you have to create things. That's how you manifest. If you want something, you gotta hold out. Wait till you get it. If you don't get it, that's fine. But I'd rather have nothing than to have what these motherfuckers is giving out. You know what I mean? What they're giving out is fake shit. You know what I mean? Some motherfuckers targeted visuals. It's like, oh, you know, I wish I could get in a relationship. I wish I could do that. It's like saying, I wish I could have steak, but I know the steak is full of fucking poison. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, steak tastes great. Steak is fucking awesome. It tastes fucking delicious. Prime rib, man. But if I know this shit poison, it's like, it might taste good. It might smell good, but I don't want it because I know if I eat it, I'm going to die. You know what I mean? And I'm proud of myself because, like I said, this is my first time in my entire life that I was able to kind of like abstain from these kind of things because I was in this program my whole life. I mean, when I say my whole life, I remember being just a teenager. I was a really fast kind of girl. And what they do is they put, this is how they do the teenage and child trafficking. They put you in a fucked up situation, you know, where you don't really got no money and stuff like that. And you got to date older guys so you can get money. And that was kind of like the situation I was in. as a teenager. I used to date like niggas that work for the city. Like, you know, I used to date these niggas. They was gang stalkers too. And when I dated them, you know, things was cool, but you know what I mean? It always was a narcissistic kind of like bad relationship. And it's been like that even till now, now that I'm an older adult. And that's why I chose a different route. Like, I could have definitely said, well, let me try again. I had options. A lot of guys, you know, I was talking to or whatever, I mean, they really tried to set me up with these kind of men that, you know, have all this flashy money and stuff. But it's like I said, once you kind of like know the truth, you can't go just for what the world tells you is this, you know. The world tells you that the police is good and they're the worst people in the entire world. And they tell you the justice system is good and the justice system is beyond broken, beyond repair. And they tell you that the government is good. The government is absolute fucking trash. Trash. I mean, if there's something worse than trash, then that's what the government is. You know? But that's what the world tells you. You know what I mean? So, once I kind of like knew the truth, I said, you know what? I'm going to abstain from all this kind of stuff. And I feel very proud of myself because one, it taught me a lot of things. First thing first, like, I'm fucking resilient. Like, these people have done so many things to me you don't even fucking know. Yeah, I put curses on them because, bitch, you know what I mean? You have the right to defend yourself. You might not want to be a physically violent person, but that don't mean I'm not going to speak and manifest bad things against you, because I will. I physically hurt somebody, bitch, I'm going to jail. I manifest things against you, bitch, you might get in a car crash or a goddamn plane crash or get stabbed and killed and shot. And it was I who manifested it against you, and I won't go to jail for it. But that's just how the cookie crumbles. But aside from that, I'm proud of the fact that I am resilient, that I chose a different path this time around. I chose to do things my way. You know, I didn't let anyone influence me into doing something that I didn't want to do. Like, this time I chose, you know, my own shit. And I'm just, you know, I just want to say I'm proud of myself, you know. It just feels, it's a different kind of, like, flex, you know what I mean? Before, I used to be like, yeah, I would get up and go to work and go out and anywhere I would go, it was always in mind, like, okay, I need to find a mate. Like, all the time. Anytime I was single, I need to find a mate. Because that's what the world tells you. It's everything is better in twos. Everything is better in pairs. You need to find a mate. And this time around, I said, fuck the mate. You know, I'm not going to go this route. I'm going to just be by myself. Because, you know, even just not smoking weed. I love smoking weed, like I said. But smoking weed is... right now is not a good idea because, you feel me, how am I gonna save money if I'm out here smoking weed? You feel me? So I chose the another path. I like smoking weed, but for now I need to abstain because I need to be able to save some money. And like, I feel proud of myself to be able to do these things, because these people, they thought they knew everything about me. They don't know shit about me. They thought I was like, they literally have fucked up my life from the beginning of time, had me get raped in situations, had, you know, men gang stalk me and do all kinds of fucked up shit. And they thought, well, she's a hoe. She's always gonna keep coming back to the dick. She's always gonna need a man in her life. And I proved them fucking wrong. Like, bitch, I'm out here doing it and I don't need a man to help me with nothing. You know? Not only that, weed. They fucked me up so bad from all the trauma that they have put in my life in this fucked up program. You know, that's like, that's how we have addicts and people who smoke cigarettes. We have addicts because they broke you as a child. They allowed you to have such abuse mentally, physically, sexually, and then you become an addict because the only thing that can help you cope with that pain is addiction. And they're the ones who are offering you the AA and the NA, you know. That's why I never fell for that shit, because they always had this demonic presence to it. But after these people have gang stalked me my whole life and caused all these calamities all around me, and I turned to weed, to cope, to forget, to numb the pain that these people had caused and inflicted on me. I was an addict. I'm not even an addict. I like fucking smoking weed. I'm not gonna lie to you, but they thought they had me, you know? They think they're God. These people are such fucking pussies. I was smoking weed last year. They had a motherfucking stupid ass, fat, nasty ass drug dealer on Tamarind in West Palm Beach, Florida. Tamarind is the hood. This nigga poisoned my motherfucking weed. Even my mama don't smoke weed, but my mama was like, that nigga crazy. Like, how the fuck you paid a nigga money for weed and he poisoned your shit? That's a bad weed dealer. I said the same thing. I understand if I'm bugging a motherfucker, keep bumming bitches out for weed. Yeah, I'll poison your shit so you can stop asking me. But bitch, I paid my hard-earned money. I used to drive DoorDash back then. And I paid you my hard-earned money and you poisoned my weed. So after that, I kind of was like, okay, you know what? If every time I buy weed, I got to be worried about poison, I'm just not going to smoke weed no more. But it was a blessing in disguise because these people, they thought they was going to break me. Like, they literally did everything to break me. They did everything. They took away my children. Not only did they take away my children, they do dream manipulation on me. And every time they do dream manipulation, what they do is they send me dreams about my son getting raped. And no, I'm not lying. Any person who was a targeted individual, you know that dream manipulation is real. And it's not even a fake thing. Everything that they do is online in the open. All the electronics and things that they have. So what they do when they do it to me is they send me dreams of my son being raped and sometimes abused and beaten and things like that. They took my children away from me. They know that my children are being raped. They send me the nightmares of my children being raped. They follow me around and stick their fingers in their ass to make fun of my children for being raped. They've tried to ram me off the road. They poisoned my frappe at McDonald's. So I don't eat at McDonald's. I don't eat at no restaurants anymore either. Because, like I said, nothing is free. I pay hard-earned money. Like, just because you're a restaurant don't mean nothing. Like, y'all restaurant could be here today and gone tomorrow. That's why McDonald's going through what they're going through. A lot of these restaurants going to be closed because, bitch, you got God fucked up. But I used to pay my hard-earned money to go to restaurants and eat. And they used to be spitting in my shit and putting poison in my shit. I don't got to be spending my hard-earned money at a restaurant like everybody else. And you got to poison my stuff. You want to take long with my order? That's fine. But when you start doing all that type of crazy shit, I think I'm going to just keep my money. You know? But the thing is, they put a lot of pressure on me. They really did a lot of things. Even one time, they had, like, they did this to so many targeted individuals. They just did this weird group text. Like, one day... All this is proof, because the thing with this kind of phone here is they always keep some sort of record of your phone, you know, your texts and your calls. And like randomly one day these people started texting me, oh bitch, you kill yourself, da da da, like random numbers that I didn't know. So I just deleted them because, bitch, I don't know who you are. But they like did all types of crazy stuff. Like, I was dating in the beginning, and they had these crazy ass stupid dry pussy cunt whores put pictures of themselves and their boyfriends or husbands and then like try to gang stalk me on like OkCupid, Tinder, Plenty of Fish and shit like that. So that's why I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna not date anymore, because if everybody's a gang stalker, then I am not even gonna try to play this game. You know, it's finding a fucking piece of hay in a needle stack. You understand? It's very hard. But they've done a lot. And they wanted me to run to cigarettes because they kept trying to hint for me to smoke cigarettes. But I'm not going to go anywhere, you tell me. And now that I'm working, they keep trying to, you know, push me to go back towards weed. Like I said, I don't mind smoking weed, but everything is on my own time. That's what they do. They inflict pain on you. They give you trauma. They give you all types of fucked up shit. And then they say, well, I can mind control you. But guess what, bitch? I won. You bitches are going to be dead. And God's going to kill you and your motherfucking family and your whole bloodline. But before you die, I just want you to know that I won. Because the thing is, you did all this stuff just to try to destroy me and make me commit suicide and do all this stupid shit. But guess what, bitch? I'm still here. And I'm better and stronger than ever. And not only that, you've been doing all types of shit trying to push me back to smoking weed. But guess what, bitch? I'm not going to be buying for your fat, nasty, mustard, relish, onion, motherfucking stank, musty ass, smelling weed, smoking ass drug dealers. Okay, ho? That's what I'm letting you bitches know. I want. You ain't going to make me do what I don't want to do. When I want to smoke weed, I'm going to smoke weed. When I feel like it's time and I got my shit together, I'm going to just sit back and it'd be a nice day. But until then, feel me, I'm on my motherfucking grind. But these bitches, you know, they keep trying to nudge me in a certain direction. But let me tell you something, bitch. If you say go east, bitch, I'm finna go west. And if you say go north, bitch, I'm finna go south. Because anything you say is always gonna be a lie to me. It could be the truth. But bitch, just because it's coming out your mouth, bitch, I'm finna be like questioning it. You ain't never gonna break me. I'm not gonna break you. I'm gonna grind you into fucking powder. Grind you into fucking powder. But yeah, I'm proud of myself for being resilient. That all the things these crazy gang stalkers in the United States of America has done to me. And I had a confirmation from my mom. My mom had a prophetic dream. And she said in the dream that my ex-husband was apologizing to me, saying that he had made a mistake. And that she saw that I had came into a lot of money. A thing that I told you is that powers is real. I had always had the gift of prophetic dreams my whole entire life. Like, I always could tell the future my whole life. My whole entire life, I always could. But I used to think it was just like some freak thing. But like, I don't know. And my mom has the same gift. My grandma has the same gift. Like a lot of people in my family has this gift. We always see the future in our dreams for some reason. But my mom had a dream that my ex is going to get caught and go to jail. And she had a dream that I was going to come into a lot of money. But that money is not coming from the lottery. It's from the United States government paying me my money for my reparation and pain and suffering that they owe me. Okay? So that was just confirmation from God of the things to come. Because these people, they caught. Like I said, these motherfuckers on Palm Beach Post writing articles trying to save their ass. Because there's so many videos out there about people being gang stalked. It's literally, it's on court. They trying to redact the court date. You know, like Ghislaine Maxwell? They trying to Ghislaine Maxwell this case because the nigga was gang stalked. The man literally murdered a child because they used a child to gang stalk this man. And the man said straight up, they was gang stalking me. The police was harassing me and all this kind of stuff. And now they trying to keep the court gates hush hush. The court date hush hush. And they trying to say, oh, he's schizophrenic. No, the nigga's telling the truth. And somebody shedding light on this and something is going on. Something is shifting. These bitches finna be paying me my money. But even if you pay me my money, you ain't gonna take away these curses. Just so you know. Because when it comes to curses, it's can't take it back, Jack. You still curse. Florida. Woe to you, bitches. United States government. Woe to you, bitches. United States military. Woe you bitches to fucking hell. United States Justice Department. Woe you bitches to the deepest pit of fucking hell too, bitch. Long catch, short motherfucking run. My God is on your ass, bitch.